الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يسألك الناس عن الساعة قل إنما علمها عند الله وما يدريك لعل الساعة تكون قريبا. إن الله لعن الكافرين وأعد لهم سعيرا خالدين فيها أبدا لا يجدون وليا ولا نصيرا. يوم تقلب وجوههم في النار يقولون يا ليتنا أطعنا الله وأطعنا الرسولا وقالوا ربنا إنا أطعنا سادتنا وكبراءنا فضلونا السبيلا. ربنا آتهم ضعفين من العذاب والعنهم لعنا كبيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين آذوا موسى فبرأه الله مما قالوا وكان عند الله وجيها. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. يعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. صدق الله العلي العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله. أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وقنا عذاب النار يا رب العالمين. محترم بزرگان دین سامعین کرام حاضرین کرام اور سامعین کرام اور تذرا سمانیتو উপস্থিত শ্রোতা কলাসনা শূন্যওয়ালা ঘর থেকে যারা শুনরা মাই বিলাভিড মাদার্স রেসপেক্টিভ মাদার্স এন্ড এল্ডার্স এন্ড ইয়াংস্টার্স লিসনিং অলসো লিসনিং ফ্রম হোম. ফিউ ভার্সেস অফ সূরা আহজাব ইন ফ্যাক্ট দ্য লাস্ট রুকু অফ সূরা আহজাব আর রিসাইটেড. আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা মেনশনস আ ফিউ টিপস এন্ড গাইডলাইন্স আফটার মেনশনিং রিগার্ডিং দ্য হাউসহোল্ড অফ রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম and regarding a few battles that took place and regarding the etiquettes and morals of the social etiquettes and social life of the family and domestic life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam household. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in this surah not to ridicule any Muslims, or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or his family members, his male folk or women folk, and the resultant consequences of these kind of actions of slandering, etc. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surah Ahzabo Fahul Fahila Khoyakta Juddur Ghatana Ful Khwarabadir Huzre Paak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or family Ahle Bayt Azwaj Mutahirat Ummahat Mu'mineen Karar Izzat Ikram Shumande Al-Sunna Huriya Tararu Fizze Bukhtan Tullahu Isil Ashi Subhi Al-Bi Khura Isil Ogula Rekhiyar Huriya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala কিছু সুরারে শেষ করা কেমত স্মরণ করাইয়া যে যা কিছু কর তা একদিন মত হইবার ইকার মনে রাখি আর কেমতর দিন ঘটব আমাকে চাইতে হইবার হিসাব কিতাব হবে তো কেমতর ওয়াজ হুনি হুনি কেমতর কথা হুনি হুনি ডেয়ার জাজমেন্ট সম্বন্ধে লেকচার হুনি হুনি মক্কার মুশরিকিন আর কুফার আর যারা খুব বেশি কাফির মুশরিক আসলে খুব বেশি আপনার শয়তান টাইপের আসলে তারা আর হৃদয় হইতো না কিয়ামত কোন দিন ঘটবে তো হুজুর পাক সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম কইলা যে ও আমার সাহাবী তুমি যে কারে কিয়ামত কোন দিন ঘটবে তো তা লাগে তুমি রেডি হয়ে গেছো কিয়ামত লাগি ও তো জলদি কিয়ামত দেখতে চাও কি লাগে বলি আর সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম কিয়ামত কোন দিন ঘটবে আল্লাহর রাসূল জি কইলা যে ঠিক আছে তো সাই তুমি কিয়ামত লাগি রেডি হইছো কতখান প্রস্তুতি হইছো কতখান রেডি হইছো কতখান প্রিপারেশন হইছো ওয়ান সাহাবী কেন কি রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম এন্ড আস্ক রিগার্ডিং কিয়ামত দ্য ফাইনাল আওয়ার দ্য ডে অফ জাজমেন্ট তার ও ফরগট আল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম When will Qiyamah occur? When will the world finish? When will the Day of Judgment come? When will the final hour, which is promised in the Quran and Sunnah, and we've been listening since 1400 years to all the members, through the prophets and imams and lectures, and now we have social media and YouTube, Qiyamah, 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 when will this Qiyamah come? Alayhi salam. So, the Mushrikeen Makkah Kufar, they also asked the same question. They said, Yes, Aluka, Nasa, Anisa, that People ask you, the people of Makkah, they keep on asking you that when is Qiyamah, when is Qiyamah, when is Qiyamah? End of another surah, Surah Luqman or other surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions five things the knowledge of only He knows. First of which Allah ta'ala appoint another surah, and Qabud by Luqman or Echevi. First of which the tar ilim ar gyan, kun din uibo, kun shubo uibo, khotohan uibo, khotofuto uibo, kun tarik uibo, kun obosta uibo, khar shamnu uibo, khar kisi, এটা বলতে আল শুধু আল্লাহ তাআলা জানেন ফাস্তা জিনিস এর মধ্যে একটা হলো কিয়ামতের দিন when will কিয়ামত come when will কিয়ামত happen what day will it come how will it come what situation it will come all these details is only known and only disclosed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says qul innamal ilmu indallah to tell them that only Allah knows even the prophet doesn't know when kiyamah is coming But Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us that ana wa sa'a ka hatay that ami ar kiamatar dinon asono beshkom otokan jotokhan amar dui angulon asono beshkom me and kiama between us the difference is the difference between my two fingers my shahada finger and my wusta sababa wusta my middle finger shahada shahadatul finger angul itara shahadatul angul dan ashadu allah qur'an atiyatu itara ko shahadatul angul to shahadatul angul ar nazar angul ekhano milaiya চেষ্টা করবা সুদ ইত্যাদি আর শরাবের নাম বদলাইয়া এটা হালাল করবার চেষ্টা করবা আর এটা হলতা একবারে যত গুণা আছে কবিরা সবিরা ছোট বড় যত বিহাইয়াই আছে আর যত ধরনের খারাপ কাম আছে হলতো দুনিয়া চলবো এবং মুসলমান দেশে আরো বেশি চলবো জুলা চলে আমরা ওগুলো জানা আছে হ্যাঁ ইতো ছোট ছোট আলামত হল মা বাপের নাফরমানি করা উস্তাদের নাফরমানি করা এবং আপনার তাগিয়ির খালক আল্লাহ তাআলার যে ক্রিয়েশন
আল্লাহ তালার যে আল্লাহ তালা ঘরে বানাইছই ও জিনিস রে আর ও ব্যক্তি রে আর ও সমাজ রে আর ও অবস্থা রে বদলাইয়া বদলাওয়া এমন ভাবে অদল বদল করা যে আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিনে আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিনে যে ন্যাচুরাল ভাবে যে জিনিস গুলা রাখছো ইটার আসলিয়ত রে বদলাই দেওয়া আর এটারে একেবারে যে বন্ধ রাখা বেটা সবসময় বেটা আছে আর বেটি সবসময় বেটি আছে কিন্তু এখন আপনার এমন সার্জারি আর ক্লিনিক অকল বার হয়েছে আর মেশিন অকল বার হয়েছে আর খেল অকল বার হয়েছে আর অবস্থা অকল বার হয়েছে আর ক্যাম্পেইন পর্যন্ত করার যে বেটাই অকল খুশি নাই তারা বেটি হয়ে দিতা আর বেটি অকল খুশি নাই তারা বেটা হয়ে দিতা ট্রান্সজেন্ডার হ্যাঁ সেক্স চেঞ্জ ট্রান্সজেন্ডার এটা আগে আসিল নি চোদ্দ বছর আগে এটা আগে আসিল না তো শয়তানে যখন গুমরা হয়েছে তখন শয়তানে ওয়াদা লইয়া আইছিল আল্লাহর কাছে থাকি যে ফালা ইউগাইরুন্না খালকাল্লাহ That you will take everyone to hell, you will destroy, deviate and divert everyone. But any of my bondsmen, any of my servants, if they lift their hands and they remember and they regret to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, then I shall forgive them. And you will keep on leading them astray and I shall keep on forgiving them until the day of judgment comes, the day which people are asking Rasulullah for continuously. That final day and final hour comes. Then we will see who has passed and who has failed, who has gone to Jannah, who has gone to hell, who has pleased Allah Ta'ala, who has displeased Allah Ta'ala, who has acquired and achieved the intercession and subhanahu of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and who hasn't received the intercession of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this Sahabi came and he said, Ya Rasulullah, when is Qiyamah? So Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was surprised that you're asking for Qiyamah. People saying, Oh Allah, save us from the Qiyamah. কেমন হবে এই বোধ আইব ওইটা তো খালি আল্লাহ ধরেন আর কেউ ধরেন আমিও ধরেন আমরাও ধরেন কেউ ধরেন না নবীও ধরেন না এতে কিতাব আর হইল যে আলিমুল গায়ব শুধু হে হু ইজ আলিমুল গায়ব দ্য পারসন হু হ্যাজ দ্য নলেজ আলটিমেট নলেজ অফ দ্য আলটিমেট আনসিন অনলি আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা ওয়াল্লাহু আল্লাযী লা ইলাহা ইল্লাহু হু আলিমুল গায়ব ওয়াশ শাহাদা অনলি আলিমুল গায়ব ইজ আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা নোবডি এলস ইফ এনিওয়ান বিলিভস দ্যাট অ্যাপার্ট ফ্রম আল্লাহ হি শেয়ারস দিস নলেজ অফ আনসিন এন্ড সলিটি with anyone else, then that will become tantamount, not only tantamount, but that will become precisely something what we call ascribing partnership to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Arabic, which is called shirk. Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bihi wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalika liman yasha. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. Two different places Allah says this kind of ascribing partnership to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether we believe or anyone believes that his being and that of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or one of his sifat and qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Rahman, Rahim, Shadidul Iqab, Ghafurur Rahim, Malikul Mulk, Dhul Jalali wal Ikram, all these Alimul Ghaybi wa Shahada Allamul Ghuyub, this is also a quality which is exclusive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nobody else knows the ghayb. Just because we know a little bit of Jannah and Jahannam doesn't mean we are Alimul Ghayb. Allah Ta'ala informed us through Quran and Sunnah regarding these things. So it doesn't become alimul ghaib. Yes, those things were in the ghaib. But once through the angel, through the wahi, through the revelation, it's become known by everyone. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, he had extra knowledge. He has much more knowledge. But he also told us that Mahdi alayhi wa sallam is going to come. Isa alayhi wa sallam is going to come. Dajjal is going to come. Yajuj Manjuj is going to come. And so is going to happen. You know, signs of Qiyamah, big signs, small signs, the sun's going to rise from the other side, etc., etc. Prophet ﷺ told us through the angel Jibreel ﷺ, if Jibreel wasn't there, if Wahi wasn't there, if revelation wasn't there, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again says in the Quran that, O Rasulullah ﷺ, لَا تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ, that you did not know what was the Kitab and what was Iman. You had no knowledge ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء. But we gave you a نور, we gave you a light, we gave you هدايه and guidance. ويهديك صراطا مستقيما. We increased this نور, we increased this هدايه and guidance, and we gave you ultimate and complete knowledge. Not like the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most knowledgeable person is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. After that, the most knowledgeable people are his sahaba. After that, the most knowledgeable people are the tabi'in and tabi' tabi'in, and so on. So this sahabi was asked that, oh my beloved sahabi, you say you want to know when will Qiyamah come? There are some weak hadiths which mention the day of Friday, they mention the time of Asr Salah. And these are small indications, small ishara, where how will Qiyamah come, when will Qiyamah come. And, he mentions the month of Muharram, etc., etc. But the signs that we should know, and many of us know, are more important. They are more important, they will definitely occur before Qiyamah. If these signs occur and take place, like nowadays, there's war and killing and murder so much all over the world now. Not only in Syria and Burma and other places, but Sri Lanka has come onto the news. Problems are happening in Sri Lanka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of the Muslims all over the world and guide the Zalimeen and guide them as well or destroy them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يسألك الناس عن الساعة قل إنما العلم عند الله. The knowledge of Qiyamah, knowledge of the last day, only belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm not prepared for it, but I love Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you will be with those who you love. Obviously you are practicing to achieve that love, which will eventually take you into, Jannatul Firdaus and paradise and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this verse, they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. Yes, regarding Syria, I was going to say that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that something called a haraj will occur. Something called, haraj will occur before Qiyamah as a sign of Qiyamah. So Sahaba asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is haraj? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-qatl wal-qitaal. That murder, killings and killings, bloodshed, ocean of blood, river of blood, forest of blood, jungle of blood, you will dream blood, and eventually God knows maybe even eat and drink blood. This is what is happening all over the world now. Why? Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Al-Qatilu wal-Maqtulu fi nar. In one hadith, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that the murderer and the murdered both will go to fire of hell if their intention was to kill each other. Whether they, obviously non-Muslim will go to the hellfire anyway. I'm talking about Muslims over here. And the other haraj is that people will be murdered mercilessly like chicken slaughtered in slaughterhouses, even more mercilessly and easily, like nothing has happened. Human being is nothing. Human flesh is nothing. A soul and a heart is nothing. On one hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that break my Kaaba, I don't mind so much. But hurt a Muslim or a person's heart, let alone murder him and kill him or do anything bad, then this is even worse. So, qatl will occur in such a wide scale and in wide area all over the world, and so much to the effect that the person killed will not know how he was killed, when he was killed, who killed him, who murdered him, and why, what's going on in the world. People will be confused. So they asked, يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ, that when will Qiyamah occur? So they were told, قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. So tell everyone and your followers that Qiyamah, the when will Qiyamah occur, the day and date and time and everything of the final hour and judgment day, the knowledge is only known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nobody else. Likewise, when under the there's many other verses and the rail to prove that Alimul Ghaib and the person who knows the unseen completely and fully is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, then Allah ta'ala says, وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا. That what do you know when Qiyamah will occur, our beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا. Maybe it's right in front of you. Maybe it's tomorrow. Maybe it's next Jum'ah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةَ هَاتَيْنِ. That the difference between me and Qiyamah is my two fingers. The difference between me and Qiyamah is my two fingers. And Allah is saying, تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا. But what do we know regarding Qiyamah, when it will come? Perhaps it's coming right now. And Prophet ﷺ, he always used to be Bashira wa Nadira. His sifat and quality and one of his names and title and one of his responsibilities is known as Bashira wa Nadira. Nadira means that there's an enemy coming tomorrow or behind the wall or behind the mountain, or there's something very big going to happen, and the leader or the prophet or the messenger, they, you know, out of love and mercy and affection of their qawm and nation, they go to the people and they warn them. Just like a mother warns the child, that, oh my beloved child, be careful, you're going to fall down, you're going to hurt yourself. There's snow there, there's ice there, there's a lion outside, there's bad boys outside, come in the house, come inside, stay indoors. The affection of the mother to their children. Likewise, Rasulullah ﷺ's affection to the ummati and followers is much more than the mother. And Allah Ta'ala's affection is even more than the mother, 99 times more than the mother, and more than Rasulullah ﷺ. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. Beautiful verse. We should read now and then for many, many purposes. Allah Ta'ala says regarding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ. Unto you has come a beloved Rasul of Allah, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from you, amongst you, from the human beings. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُمْ. تُمْ رَضِي كُنُوا تَقْلِيفُ وَيَتْنَي أَلَّا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَيَوْا قُلْ بُولَا لِيَا عَنِتُمْ مَا لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُمْ. If you have any difficulty, if you hurt yourself, if the ummah is hurting and in pain and burning and boiling and bleeding, then who is feeling it most? Our poor beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right now in his grave, he is also feeling it. Right now in his grave, he believes he is alive, he is feeling it. Over there, if we say, As-salatu as-salamu alayhi wa sallam, directly there is no need of an angel to convey over there. Directly Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hears us from there. And he replies with our name and our parents' name, and recognizes every single follower. From here, the angels, they convey over there. Friday, we should read Durood Sharif as much as we can, send salutation and peace of beloved Prophet. Just today, I was having a look at two verses. One is the famous verse that we know, إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. That Allah sends Durood and blessings to the Prophet, and the angels also send Durood and blessings to the Prophet, and we Muslims are also ordered to send Durood and blessings and salutations to the Prophet. But there's another verse in a different surah, Surah Ahzab, that Allah Ta'ala says that Allah sends durood and blessings to the Prophet, the angel sends durood and blessings to the Prophet, the Muslimin send durood and blessings to the Prophet, the meaning of which is that Allah Ta'ala is sending salam to the Prophet, and the angels are doing istighfar, and the mu'mineen are supposed to do dua and salam for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the purpose of this, what will happen through this durood and salam on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially on Fridays and other days as well, لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. In Surah Azhar, Allah Ta'ala says that I send durood, angels send durood, believers, male and female, everyone sends durood with all their intentions and all their good intentions and desires, you know, on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for their benefit. And what happens in return? لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us out from zulumat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us out from the darkness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us out from the darkness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take us out from the darkness. Zoto ndokar ase, zoto darkness ase, zoto zulumat ase, zoto shumushya ase, zoto problems ase. All the problems the ummah is facing is in this zulumat. Ndokar, darkness. You know, whatever is going on in Syria, we are helpless. If that happens to us, we are done. You know, if anyone touches our wife because the government said so, our children, our women, our houses, our factories, our businesses, what can we do? What can the people of Syria do? What can the people of Burma do? They are helpless, we are helpless, we are mazloom. They are even more mazloom. Allahumma ansur al-mazloomin. Allah Ta'ala taught us a dua that, oh Allah, help the oppressed. The dua between the oppressed, the call and dua and cry of the oppressed, the mazloom, his dua and all the farda and everything in between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is lifted. There's no gap and no parda and no veil between the dua and the qawla of the oppressed. Even if he's a non-Muslim, there's no where and no further between him and between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does that mean? That means the cry and dua and the anger and the depression and the stress of the ummah, especially the Muslimin, especially those who are Muslim, those who have been oppressed by force without any reason, just because they're Muslim, just because of racial hatred or whatever, then their dua and their call and cry reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala straight away, breaking through his seven stars and arsh direct onto the lap of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, direct in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servant, O my oppressed servant, don't worry, wait, mata nasrullah ala inna nasrullahi qareeb. That we say in Bangla and Urdu, we say that andher mehi hai dher hai, something like this, isn't it, in Urdu. Bangla yo wala yakutar se. The andher ana yakut dheriya se, yakut sabar horo. Allah Ta'ala says, you know, in one of the battles, they were really fed up, the Sahaba. Badr, Uhud, or Ahzab, or one of the big battles. So they were really fed up. And they said, Ya Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Mata Nasrullah, when will the help of Allah come? Sahaba will fed up with the same Buzuka. I'm rather fed up with Allah. We can understand why shouldn't the Ummah be fed up now? Even though we shouldn't lose hope, we shouldn't be that fed up. We should do sabr and be patient. This is our test and trial. Allah Ta'ala will give us Jannah because of this. Allah will forgive all our sins. And those who die on kufr and shirk and zulum, they will go to the fire of hell forever and ever. The Sahabas even said to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Mata Nasrullah. Kunshuma Allah Shahid Jaibu. Ala inna Nasrullah Qareeb. At one point they said, Ya Rasulullah, Udu'u lil Mushrikeen. That pray against the Mushrikeen. Curse them. You know, they've done enough. They've gone too far. They've oppressed us and depressed us. They hate Islam and Muslims. Just because وَمَا نَقَرُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. The only reason why they oppress you and depress you, and the only reason why they harm you, the only reason why they touch you, the only reason why they kick you out of your own countries, despite you being your citizens of your own country, like Burma, they are the original people of Burma. They are the original people of, what is it called, Burma, Arakan. They are the original people. The Buddhists are not even, they don't even belong to that country. The original people are the Burmese people. Burma, Ashul, Arakan, or the Ashul Manoj, Itiyashik Babe, historically, for thousands of years, that has been their country. It's a beautiful country. That has been their homeland. They've been kicked out. Quran Sunnah always mentions these things. The Muslims will be kicked out. Why? وَمَا نَقَبُوا مِنُهُمْ إِلَّا يُؤْمِنُوا إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَمِيرِ. In Surah Buruj. Similar things happen in Surah Buruj. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ. The people of Ukhdud, they were burnt alive as well. The people of Ukhdud, they were killed and murdered as well. The people of Ukhdud, their trenches were built. They were thrown into the trenches. Already in this day and age, 21st century, you know, with all this technology and everything we have, everyone, you and me and all of us, have seen pictures on social media that they have built trenches and they have thrown them in there and they have killed them, you know, or with fire, oil and guns and whatever, shot them to death. This is happening now. Why? Just because of one reason, nothing else. Khali ek harune, sif ek cheez ke liye. Just because of one reason, that's because illa yu'minu billahi al-azim. Because we have iman on Allah and Rasulullah. They understand how valuable iman is. Can you understand what I'm saying? They understand, otherwise if they did not understand how valuable iman is, why are they so jealous of us? Why do they want to stretch this away? If you really understand how valuable and qimti iman is, then accept it, become a Muslim, become our brother, shake hands with us properly, sincerely. Don't be a munafiq, don't be a hypocrite, don't be 50-50, you know. Be a true Muslim, be a true brother, inshallah we all go to Jannah together. But the world is full of munafiqs. إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُهُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَاذِبُونَ. These are liars and fraudsters, and these are, you know, munafiqeen and hypocrites who say we have got iman, we are with Muslims, we are well-wishers, we want the goodness of the world, we are fighting terrorism. Are you causing terrorism or fighting terrorism? Or do you need some education and a class to learn what is terrorism? You know, do you need that word spelled out for you, you know, in a class, that what is terrorism? It looks like they have forgotten what is terrorism. They can make their own dictionary now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the only reason why Muslims are always hurt and always, you know, oppressed is because of iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْإِنَّتِكَمْ. Allah uses the word manna, that أَنَا هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ. that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored us by giving us Iman. Iman is something so precious and so valuable and so, you know, priceless. No price of any diamond or silver or gold or money or the world, seven earth and heaven, everything put together can't come near a person who has this, you know, valuable, this treasure of Iman, this dollar of Iman. So these people, they want to snatch our Iman and Islam away. Like I mentioned before, the dua is such a weapon of mass destruction, a spiritual weapon of mass destruction, that they can't snatch away ever. We can do dua in prison, we can do dua in our bedroom, we can do dua in our workplace, we can do dua while driving to and from work and masjid, we can do dua after salah, before salah, in salah, etc. etc. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَعْنَ الْكَافِرِينَ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ سَعِيرًا, that verily Allah ta'ala has cursed this kind of kuffar, وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ سَعِيرًا, who those, especially those who are bent upon having Islam and the Muslims, as the holy sites of the Muslims all over the world, لَا يَجِدُونَ وَلِيًّا وَلَا نَصِيرًا, they will never find any helper. And then in the other verse, Allah Ta'ala, when they ask that when will the help of Allah come, Allah Ta'ala said, أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ, that behold, listen, Allah Ta'ala's help is very close. Sunlo Allah Ta'ala ki nusrat bohut hi qareeb hai, Allah Ta'ala shahid jo anek ki kutbohti, Allah Ta'ala's help and nusra is very close. Then Allah Ta'ala says, that يَوْمَ تُقَلَّبُ وُجُوهُمْ, on the day when their faces of the kuffar and mushrikeen and munafiqeen will be turned left, right, center in the fire, they will say, يَا لَيْتَنَا أَطَعْنَ اللَّهُ وَعَطَعْنَا الرَّسُولَ, kaash ke hum Allah Rasul ki sun lete, afsus hum Rasul ki Allah Rasul ko pata nahi tha. When they see the fire with their own eyes, they will forget their own fire of the world and everything, all the joy of the world, and they will say, oh, that others, you know, only if we followed Allah and obeyed Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the next verse, Allah Ta'ala says, regarding political leaders and leaders of every nation and every community and society and, you know, educated people, Allah Ta'ala says that even the elders and leaders of every community, when they see the consequences of their doings in the Akhirah, they will also say that أَطَعْنَ اللَّهَ كُبَرَانَا وَسَادَتَنَا, that only if we did not listen to our elders. So if we did not listen to our leaders and our elders, then we would not have gone astray. If we ignored them or if we gave them dawah instead, then we would have gone to Jannah and to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to understand these things.